His job was to clean the foreskin of Sophie the horse, even though that was a woman.
Horse hockey. It's the proverbial piece of baklava, sir. I love how everyone on MASH had the most ridiculous vocabulary in the end, these giant words. Isn't he a high school dropout from Toledo?
That is true, yes.
Yeah. What's he saying proverbial for?
Looking back on MASH, the humor doesn't work for me anymore at all. But I love a lot of the serious stuff they did.
And we lost a MASH guy.
Who?
Who was it? It's in the paper. Died?
What?
A guy who directed MASH.
Yeah, behind the scenes guy.
I didn't recognize his name.
You didn't recognize his name?
I like the ones, my brother always points out, the best chunk, the best run on MASH, the best era is when BJ... before he grew the mustache, when Frank Burns was still there.
Yes, Frank Burns was still there.
Those episodes are amazing. And those are actually, a lot of them are really funny, because those were the first where they would do episodes without plots. It was just, we're in the operating theater, and there's nothing really overall happening. It's just a bunch of little events.
Yeah, they're kind of drinking or playing poker or something, and then they're trying to get through the night,
and it's like, oh, this is great. There's no... they're not setting up any goofy jokes. It's just real life. You know, it felt really cool.
Fucking Frank Burns. They said that was one of the greatest regrets they had about MASH, that they didn't allow Larry Linville to develop as who he was. Because he was a funny character, but they left him one level.
And they could have added, and I always say, if MASH were made today, the top comedian, the star on the show, would fight to play Frank Burns and not Hawkeye. Because now, if you notice, the best comedian characters, people like Larry Sanders and David Brent from The Office, they want to play the damaged assholes.
Right.
And not the self-righteous guy that's
a little more.
Exactly. And if you made MASH now, like Will Ferrell would want to play Frank Burns and not Hawkeye. Wow. And who would be amazing at it, because you could do great satire.
When do we get to the point where we can make war sitcoms again? Hogan's Heroes.
It'll eventually.
Hogan's Heroes always made me laugh, because it's like, even as a kid, I didn't quite feel right about, hey, it's a sitcom and there's swastikas in it.
It was just the oddest thing.
It's like canned laughter's going off and there's a picture of Hitler and they're fucking...
Yeah.
It's like, hey, that's a little odd.
Who the fuck was in charge back then to allow that to happen?
It's a sitcom about Nazis.
it's a talent show being run by Oscar Schindler. It's a little odd.
Who's in charge of the network?
No, the Nazis, all right. They made him look a little goofy and stuff.
Well, wasn't it the guy that played Klink? Because I think his...
He was Jewish.
Yeah, he was Jewish, and I think some of his relatives died in the Holocaust.
Werner Klimperer.
And he said, I'll take this role, but... Klink can never win. He always has to lose.
Yeah, he would be the goofy guy that always lost.
He has to be
lost.
The butt of the joke. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. So. Oh, it would be great if they wrote an episode where he had to actually kill all of Hogan's heroes.
And look, Amon Gert is doing the eyebrow raise. He's a card.
All right.
He's a card.
Hogan, get your men. Have them dig ditches. Yeah. Dig a big long ditch in the woods, Hogan.
She left a ring in the tub. Canned laughter. Oh, that red dress. That shouldn't be colorized. What a nut.
Do a slide whistle every time Amon shoots out the window.
The prop ricochet shot.
And then he's talking like, I feel like my bullets, it's like all like veiled erection jokes. I feel like my bullets are just going 2 inches and falling down.
People are dying. It's horrific.
Yeah. Having a barbecue today?
Not exactly. They were always trying to rig the old ball bearing plant to blow up Hogan and his men. They'd have to go out the tree stump and come back. And again, as a kid, I didn't quite understand like what they were doing. I was like, if they're out of the camp, why don't they just fucking
just
leave?
Just keep going.
Yeah.
I never understood heroics. Like, you're a kid, so it's not like you don't understand what a guy that would have a mission or something. It's like, hey, they're out. Why don't they just fucking leave?
Yeah, let's go.
Why is he going back?
Theme of that show is a big part of my growing up, because it just always seemed to be playing in the background.
In the background on some TV. With a drunk relative laughing at it. Going, God damn, why'd they lose?
I wish we'd had Hogan when I was in the Ardennes Forest. We could have used that son of a bitch. A tunnel under the doghouse.
Look at that. It's lifting up. The dog doesn't even care.
Stupid Nazi dog.
He likes him, see, because even the dog's pleasant.
My wife doesn't fuck.
Hogan, yeah, Hogan's Heroes was a. Well, you know that we'll finally get over 9/11 as a nation when in 60 years they make a cheesy Pearl Harbor style romance.
Yes.
Titanic style movie about 9/11.
About it, where it doesn't really matter the horror of it. It's more the romance. And...
Well, there's a young stockbroker in the tower, and he's in love with a sandwich girl, and she's trying to work her way. So all that's happening in the backdrop of that morning.
And then
they're in the tower as it collapses and have to proclaim their love. Like, you know that's coming.
Yeah.
You know that's maybe not soon, but will happen.
Enough time goes by, and we've always talked about this. And people took this for granted. It's like you watch a party going on or a little fair, and kids are sliding down this ship that looks like it's halfway into the lawn, and it's a water slide.
I know, I've seen that.
And it's the Titanic ride.
I know.
And it's like they made a ride out of a shipwreck where thousands died in frigid waters.
Yeah.
And the most horrific death. And then enough time went by where it was an inflatable ride that children, you know, and they're bouncing off the smokestack and, this is fun. Yeah.
There's salt and pepper shakers you can get. It's the Titanic sinking.
Titanic sinking.
It's the thing sticking up. Yeah, I'm
so
not kidding.
So when will the World Trade Center be like a ride where maybe even a bigger one at MGM?
Oh, like that Twilight Zone
Tower
thing
of Terror. Yeah.
Oh, my
Something
God.
Something like that, where it's like, whoa, hey, the World Trade Center ride. Look out, people.
If you told people in 41 that, this Pearl Harbor thing, this is going to be a really cheesy romantic
cheesy
movie.
Cheesy bad movie.
What? Yeah. Oh, yeah. With a young people, and she's a nurse, and he's a pilot, and they're kind of in love on the island. Are you – this is
– No, this is horrible.
This is
I know people.
That.
They just died.
No. Just give it some time. People will be cool with it.
Yeah, they'll be cool.
They won't? They will. They really
will. Don't worry about it.
Yeah.
What was the last comedy about a war that was made? Was it MASH?
I'll say that not that this is a sitcom, but we had Chris Morrison, Young Lions, about the four suicide bombers.
Oh, my God.
Oh, Four Lions.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
All right.
Four Lions. Young Lions with Brando. Four Lions was great.
Was that really totally comedy?
Yes.
I know. I saw it. It was great.
Chris Morris, that guy, any comedian that has to flee the country after the episode of your show, the one he did. You ever see The Brass Eye?
No, I've heard. I know. I'm familiar with it. But
he did this thing about the danger of pedophiles. It's a fake news show. So then they it's more about the hysteria about pedophilia. It's not actually about, because at the time in England, people were going nuts that they burned down a pediatrician's house. They didn't understand the difference between,
that's Jesus
how crazy it got.
Christ, okay,
so at one point,
bad.
He was doing this hidden report, and it's just a picture of a school. He goes, this clever pedophile has disguised himself as a school. and then he had to leave England. People were calling for his head.
Wow.
And of course, the point he was making about all the news program hysteria, then they did all these shows about how awful his show was and totally proved his point.
Yeah, well,
he was the news for a month.
Well, we were doing that with news teases about how, does a pedophile live next door to you? No. And then it's like, no. It does. The report comes on and goes, well, unless you live here.
Oh, yeah.
If not, no.
Oh, they'll do that with minor stuff.
No pun intended.
The local news in Los Angeles, I will put that up against any. That is the worst local news. It is high school kids are putting on a show is what they're doing. And they will tease. I remember back in the day, The X-Files, is it going to be canceled? Tune in at 11. I like that show. Tune in. Nope, it's been renewed.
They're renewed.
You can't tease a story that doesn't exist.
They would do it constantly. And here they would do more dangerous shit. Like they would tease shit that is like, is your water killing you? and just leave it at that. And you're like, all right, is it?
Yeah.
Now I got to wait? If it was,
wouldn't
you want to get the word out before people start drinking some more
water?
How about
the emergency broadcast system if the water's poisoned?
Yeah.
If the Joker just threw something in the reservoir, why do you break into Dancing with the Stars and tell us?
Shit.
Hang on, wait till 11.
We do have a bunch of those.
You
want
to do this or what?
Yeah, I would love to hear some. Right, every so often we play these.
We haven't done this in a while.
They're news teasers.
This is the Hall of Fame. We've been collecting these forever.
The Hall of Fame.
And this is the Hall of Fame. These are the best of the best news teasers.
Best of the best.
I love them. Just for you, Patton. Yeah. First, this one.
One city wants to pack all their sex offenders into a 3-block area. Problem is, it could be right next to your house.
Now, come on. Look, what kind of panicky Pete fucking alarmist shit is that?
This news story is for right one guy.
Are your relatives going to be sending your Christmas cards to Rape Street?
Yeah.
Tune in.
Could you imagine 3-block radius? It's all pedophiles. You're the only house with kids, and you're not a pedophile.
Yeah.
And you're like, wow, the news was right.
There's a candy store every 5 feet.
I know. Yes. I will say, if they did do that, and I was a little kid, I would know where to go get the candy.
Of course, yeah. Right,
I'd know
there.
Where to
just
go get treats.
Run though.
Absolutely.
Although if that existed and you were a little kid and you walked through and no one bugged you, you'd be like, oh, I really am not.
I
good
suck.
Oh,
yeah,
this is terrible.
This is, come on, guys.
Like that'd become a little kid thing. Like I walked through pedo town and little, no one even looked at
me. A little self-esteem for me here, please.
Yeah. Really, at least.
Help me out here, Hendry.
Here's the next one.
I'm trying to get this bang this old man.
Yeah, I'm doing a lot of favors for you, dear Hendry.
Come on.
Here's the next one.
How a twist on the predator law could shut down religion.
Shut down religion.
How a twist shut on down the predator religion. Law can shut down religion.
Well,
religion.
Because religion, there's like water parks. You just shut them down.
You shut them down. Sometimes you got to.
Shut down religion.
I hear over.
You know what? It didn't get so bad, so all they did was close at dusk.
Yeah.
But they reopened in the morning.
Oh, my God.
That is the most alarmist shit.
Wow.
This is the Hall of Fame.
Yeah, it's this one made the Hall of Fame, too.
Could frequent hiccups be a sign of cancer? Watch News 8 at 10.
How about just giving us a yes or no?
And you're like, and then you're hiccuping just thinking, holy shit, this sucks.
Instead of can it, how about you saying frequent hiccups is not a sign of cancer?
Yes.
That's why the media deserves no more fucking freedom than comedies get.
But somebody, yep. I bet somebody that has frequent hiccups does have cancer. But 99% of frequent hiccuping has nothing to do
and
with it.
If they don't, they should. Yeah. They're annoying everybody with their hiccuping. It's like, will you find a lump somewhere already?
Oh, shit.
Fucking buzz off.
Funny.
Here's the next one.
Oh. Are you normal? Thursday at 11 on News 8.
That wasn't cut. Are you normal? Thursday at 11. Oh, I got to wait till Thursday. Holy shit, while I hack this hooker up, I hope I'm normal.
The problem solvers have uncovered sexual predators sent to live in our nursing homes.
Do you really know who's living down the hall?
Could this happen to your mother?
Ah, shit. Oh, look out.
That sounds like another SNL bit.
The old broad's getting really, a deep dick in.
Kentucky Fried Movie or something.
Yeah, that
doesn't sound real.
Big Jim Slade.
Yeah, yeah. Here's the next one.
Could your house be making you fat? Tomorrow, CBS 2 News at 5.
Right.
What a rip.
If the walls are made of ham, sure. Oh, my God. These are guys, they're just sitting in the newsroom. Just, what's the scary phrase? Say something.
Yeah, say something.
We'll just tease that.
Let me think. Murder.
All right. Do bees buzzing? Does it mean murder?
Oh, yes.
Something.
Could buzzing bees make you murder?
Yeah.
Oh, that's good. Go with it. Where's the graphic?
That's our tease for
take
today.
Take a victory lap there,
that's
Lenny.
That's our tease today. High five.
And the ingredients in shampoo that can make a boy develop breasts tonight at 10.
What?
I wish they would tell me what that was. I'd slip it into Sam's shampoo and then seal him up when he came to work.
Black people, can they walk through walls when it rains? Tune in at 11 to find out.
I hope not. Jesus, it's raining. After my alarm isn't on.
God.
And one more in the Hall of Fame.
Here we go.
Sex offenders may be in your house at 11.
Now that's scary.
They really went all out.
Yes!
They really went all out on that one.
Unless you're a sex offender, then that story holds no interest for you. Yeah. Right? Yeah, I know that.
It's like it is. I am. You're beating off to kiddie porn. Yeah, you're right.
It should say sex offenders or federal agents could be in your house, which will get everybody to watch.
Yeah, or send people to like just tap on the walls. Hello? I got some boy ass out here.
It's a new Wes Craven movie. The pedophiles under the stairs.
Oh, shit.
I gotta piss desperately.
Well,
Nick Fortson is here too.
Coming up on the top of the hour, we might as well take a break.
Yeah.
I do want to say this. We should bring that bit back. If you find a news tease out there, please send it into the show.
Yeah.
Please.
Yeah.
Those are really old for most of the listeners. They've heard those
but you know what?
Too many times.
I've heard them every time they've heard them, and I still love hearing them.
Yeah, but let's get some new ones. So if you hear a good one, send it in. Please, we'll promote your Twitter account.
That should be hilarious.
Patton Oswalt just killing for us today. Jimmy said, Nick Swartzen is going to join the program.
Yay.
And I got word that Kevin Smith wants to call and just say hi today.
What? I finally saw Red State.
Loved it, right? I did, too.
Fucking
I fucking loved it.